Hello and welcome to Glastonbury Calling Podcast with Ian and Jem. Yeah, this week it's all about Godney. We talk about the Wax Pen Godney this year, our Godney gathering memories, plus what we got up to last week and other gigs on this week. All right, let's kick the show off with Liquid State, and this is Russian Roulette. Okay, we kicked off the show with a bit of Liquid State and Russian Roulette. Welcome to the Glastonbury Calling Podcast with Ian and Jem. All right, Jem.
Yeah, good, thank you. How are you this week?
Oh, very good, very good. Bit worn out with all the, you know, shenanigans at the weekend, but it was good. It was good. Great fun.
So what were the shenanigans like? I haven't heard of that band. Who are they?
Yeah, I know. That'd be a good name for a band if no one's shenanigans.
Can you imagine what they'll be getting at their dance steps on stage?
Yeah, yeah. We'll go back to our band name suggestions of that again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
copyright that one now, The Shenanigans.
Yeah, this is the first track from our album, the self-titled album, The Shenanigans, and the first track's called Getting Up to Nothing.
It's got to be like an Irish folk band, a bit like the Pogues, hasn't it? If you call
Or Mad Dog McRae could be a bit
Mad Dog McRae, well, something
Yeah,
it would be good. No, it was really good. We had a great event. Struggled a little bit with the rain, but you know, we're in the UK, you get a bit of rain, so they had to come brush the water off the stage. Main worry was, you know, I was looking at the lightning tracker app, and I was like, well, what are we going to do if we get lightning? Because obviously, you'd have to shut it off, wouldn't you, if you get lightning? But we managed to get away with that. But, it was a really good event, well run. Sold out for the first time ever, Summerstock did.
Great.
So they were very, very, well, everyone's very pleased with that. Music was really good. For the first time, I got to see the acts play at night, because normally I'm in the DJ tent, aren't I?
With your silent disco.
With the silent disco. So we got to see all the artists play at night. And it was really good. Loads of good food stalls there. Good. Nick Parker was excellent. He played one or two off of his new album that's going to be coming out in the near future. He's just got a little bit more to do to it. So look forward to that. Hopefully, at the end of the summer, he said, he'll get it out. So with fingers crossed, might have a Nick Parker album this year. So that would be good.
Always makes me feel happy.
Yeah.
Nick Parker makes me feel happy. Lonely Tourist makes me feel happy. There's certain musicians, Gaz Brookfield, we can name them all, couldn't we?
Yeah.
That make you just feel happy. They're just good eggs. And really excited by that, because it has been a while. And any clues as to what the new album's going to be like?
I mean, it's a Nick Parker-ish song.
The lyrics are going to be great.
No,
he writes one of my favorite lyricists in music.
No, really, really good songs that, you know, really good. I think the album's going to be good. If that's a clue to go by. I mean, his albums, I was listening to it when I was doing a post round the other day, a couple of his albums, and they're always good because he doesn't rush albums out. He's like, puts one out every 3 or 4 years. When it, you know, makes sure that he's got an album full of good tracks when he puts it out. So, you know, all killer, no filler, as they say.
Yeah, no, I had a nice time at Priddy. I managed to go to some of it. The Friday, we popped into the Fringe tent for the open mic and caught up with loads of great friends, Pete Stern and James Slater and Joe and Al Desmond's Dawn, and they did a set. So it was really lovely to see them. Al had a bit of hay fever. I hope you're feeling better, because I've got it this week. It feels, I don't normally get hay fever, so he was struggling, and I kind of had to pass on a message. Al, you're gonna play. It'll be fine. And then they put in a great set in their song. So great to catch up with them. Then Saturday came along and it did pour down. And I must say, I was so tired with my 6 days of working that at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I thought, oh, I better get out of bed now. I'm thinking the sun's coming out. I think I might just pop down to Priddy again, and then caught up with more musicians, but sort of saw Sam Evans, Two Man Ting, Amadou Jan. So it was really nice. It's a bit like Summerstock, isn't it? Lots of great local musicians playing. So yeah, really enjoyed it. It was great to be back at Priddy as well.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I got to see Matt Owens. It was lovely to see him, catch it with him. So it's nice. You know, they were one of the ones caught in the rain as well. So,
They
were really good.
I'll tell you what I did see. The Drystones, saw the Drystones play in the Village Hall. And they've really got kind of an electro set now, quite dancing. And now Ford Collier, after that, did a a four dimensional, where he then did his own disco with sort of dance folk tracks. So he did a folk disco. So I was quite impressed with that as well. So they were on good form. Really nice to see them. And what I loved about it, we've spoken this about folk music before and getting sort of youth into folk music. The whole audience, the Village Hall in Priddy, was just full of just people from the blues school, Wells Blues School, and their former mates and things. Just the average age, probably about 25. It was incredible. So it was really nice to see young people really enjoying the Dry Stones. They are at the top of their game, those
two, with their new
drummer. They've got a drummer now as well. So, so that was exciting. Yeah, so good weekend,
Well, Zanny did his best set I saw him ever do. So he was really good. And a lot of curious people were coming in and checking him out. Because he had like a face mask on and he had these weird wide brimmed reflective glasses on top of the ski mask and he put on a great show. He's like, it was his best one I've seen him do. Real good mix of stuff. And he's getting there. It won't be long,
you know. He kind of exudes talent. Yeah. You know, and what for me about Zanny is, I wonder where his music will take him in 10 years' time, because it's not going to be the same as it is now. He's happy to give anything a go. A lot of energy as well. So no, he's a very talented person.
Right, shall we play some more music?
Oh, go on then. Twist my fingernail.
Right, all the acts we're playing today are playing at the Godney Gathering, majority of them on the Glastonbury Calling stage. So thanks to Mike and Sue and the team for letting us have a stage again. This is called Dancing on the Rubble of the City, and it's by the Muriel Mathliner Band.
1, 2, 3, 4. Children, too much too young. We had a chance, but we're still not done. Our cardboard shells raced to the ground. They put us there, so we're nowhere bound. It's the same G. Our generation knows we hope for the same peace. The mighty fall, and we pick ourselves up. Now we're dancing on the rubble. Keeping us young. Children,
gonna stop hard but a broken neck. My life's kinda like a train wreck. I need another shot of adrenaline. Dragging my body through these unholy sins. I want everybody to stay calm. I'm like a ticking bomb, another shot in the dark. Because you broke my heart for too long. I think my time's up to explode. Here we go.
That's Afflicted there by the Brave Ones. And talking about Godney, it is Godney this weekend. I popped up on Monday and saw how the setup was going, and it was going really well. One bit of news about where we are now, we're going to be in a tent. So the glass recording stage, which, looking at the weather forecast, it ain't a bad thing.
Is it not looking very good?
No. I think it's meant to be okay on Saturday. I think they might get away with it on Friday. The rain seems to be moving a bit earlier. But anyway, so we're in a tent. What they've done, down on the stage we were, down the bottom, they're putting the cabaret on there because one of the issues they were getting was so many people were trying to get in the cabaret tent and it was causing a problem. And the other thing was they want to do fire acts, like, you know, and The problem is you can't do fire racks in a tent, can you? So
it has its issues, doesn't it?
It does have an issue.
You can imagine, you know, you can imagine the health and safety person doing one of these shenanigan dances.
Yeah.
If they see that happening.
Well, they've got a drag act on at the end as well. And the problem, that was one of the issues. They had a really good drag act on at the end of it last year at the cabaret, at the end of the cabaret show. And so many people were trying to get in to see the drag act. It just caused, you know, it caused too many problems. It was a safety risk. So that's why they've got it down the bottom there this year. And I'm very happy because, like the earlier days when we were in the tent, I really used to like the tent because you've got your own, you create your own intimate atmosphere and your own intimate show. So, and on top of that, they haven't got the acoustic tent this year. So we're a good one to come to that's undercover with some exciting local acts and that as well. So
The tent, the Glastonbury Calling tent, is that where the acoustic tent was last year, or is it replacing where the cabaret tent was last year?
No, so it's where the cabaret tent was and where the old silent disco was.
Okay.
Over that side.
Yeah.
So so we've got, you know, we're in a nice position, I think.
Yeah, it's nice. Not too far from the bars. Yeah, you grab a pint and then go into the calling tent at Godney.
Yeah, and one good bit of news: dispel that rumor. Every band at Godney is getting paid. So if anyone thinks that people are playing to enhance their reputation and all that sort of stuff, they're getting rid of that whole thing, and everyone there is being paid.
That's so great news.
It's great news. Especially with, you know, what Mike was saying, especially with all the fuel crisis and things like that's going on, and people having to pay a lot more to get down to the gigs. You know, they want to make sure that everyone's getting a reasonable amount of money to cover their costs. Because some of the acts were going, we don't want any, we're happy to play for nothing. But he said, no, we're going to pay you anyway, so, which is good.
Yeah, no, that's classy, I think, and well done. It's always been really, really hard, isn't it? Balancing, keeping a festival sustainable. You don't want a festival to fold because they just don't get the expenses in to pay musicians. On the other hand, the ideal is musicians get paid. They don't have to worry about their costs. They become creative because they don't have so many worries and continue to produce excellent music. So, yes, it's a big, big win. That's good news.
Yeah. So, we'll go quickly through the lineup. On the Friday night, you've got on the main stage, Dub Pistols, Filter, Electric Enemy and Stars. Electric Enemy are a rock band. From what I've heard, they sound, who do they sound like? They're very rocky and quite intense with electronics in the background. So, they're quite good. Stars are quite a poppy act. And with a female singer, and they sound really, really good. A little bit like Amy Winehouse. So that's good. On the second stage, you've got Monkey Bizzle, who are, how would you describe Monkey Bizzle? They're in the same sort of category as Mad Dog McRae, that sort of line of music anyway. Billy in the Lowground. Sort of another great folk rock band, and Misery Kids are also playing on there on the second stage. So, and they're indie pop act. So, got them. And then on the Saturday, don't forget the Silent Discos, great lineup on the Silent Disco. And then on the Saturday on the main stage, we got the Zootons, who are great, Gentlemen's Dub Club. Sherlocks, who are really, really I think, really good sign. I mean, Gentlemen's Dub Club, I mean, they're sub-headlining at Beautiful Days. The Sherlocks are going around. They've got a UK tour booked in November where they're playing the Carlin Academy. So that's really good. They've got the K's, who are another indie act who are going somewhere, starting to go places, and getting good festival bookings. Lancashire Hot Putts, the Kairos, Capello, Ruby J. On the second stage, Carl Phillips and the Rejects, who are really quite an established punk act. Bridges, who are well-known Bristol indie act. We had Bridges at Glastonbury Calling in 2016.
That's right. Was that our first Glastonbury Calling, wasn't it? I think they were on my stage then. They're really good.
Yeah, they were really good on your stage. Yeah. The Ras, who are another indie, Holy Youth Movement. The Scribes, I'm going to play a Scribe song. They've been making a name for themselves. They're a indie, folk, rock, rap act. Sort of like cover all the bases, really.
They're a Bristol band, aren't they?
Bristol. So
I tell you what's great about Godney is that a lot of these acts are actually at the. I mean, when you go into talking about the weekend, other music at the weekend as well. It's the Bristol Harbour Festival, which I used to, when I lived near Bristol, would go to. And I was looking at the acts. Quite a few of the acts that you've mentioned are actually are performing at the Bristol Harbourside Festival.
Oh, nice.
But over 100,000 people are going to go there, so it's a great atmosphere. But when you've only got 5,000 at Godney, you've got a much easier and a better chance of actually seeing the groups. And it's with a much more with the gatherers that just love music. So you're in a crowd that where people are actually going for the music, to see the music and to dance to the music, rather than everyone trying to get through a stage because they want to get an ice cream at the other side of the stage area. So that's what is special about Godney.
Right. So on our stage, so this isn't in order of appearance. We've got the Muriel Mathlin and the band, who we've had play class recording, Lewis Paul, who's great, you know, indie pop act, you know, really good. Absolute Zero, a really, really young rock act who go for it. They're all under 12, I think. So that's going to be great. That's the other thing Mike was saying. He said, oh, we've got some drinks for the bands and that this year, so I'm giving you some beer and that. I said, oh, I'll give them all to Absolute Zero and get them smashed.
So have you noticed, everyone, how Ian's then gone back to 0% beer? So he's giving the Absolute 0% beer to the group Absolute Zero. But I can imagine there's going to be a sort of, should we say, the drinks might get a little bit mixed up.
This band called Ravello Drive. I haven't got a track of theirs to play, but they're an indie act who are really good. Brave Ones, a great local rock act, and they're really good. Beware of Leopards, who played at Summerstock last week. They're playing stacks of festivals when I look at it. They were really, really good. Really good indie act, and accessible indie act, and I'd say definitely well worth a look. Liquid State, who are great, seen them loads, and really recommend them. And Grove Warden, a really heavy metal band, really one of those heavy acts. So, we're good. So it's quite a rocky lineup, quite interesting, so should be fun. So that's the lineup. The Comedy and Cabaret, what I was saying about it being moved, they've got a drag act on there called Absolutely Dragulous at the end. So I think there'll be lots of people down to see them. But they've got they've got one or two fire acts and that down there anyway. And there's some good acts on the Silent Disco, Sheridan Knight, Tom Ransom, Forgive and Forget, he's playing there as well. Connor C, Bambi Clare. So we've got some good stuff on Silent Disco as well. So plenty to keep people entertained during the day.
Well, all I can say about the fire acts, I bet they're going to be hot.
Oh, God. Dad joke. dad joke warning. Hold on. I ought to edit that out and then put this, that before you said that.
Okay.
Yeah, I think that would make sense. Dad joke warning.
Spoiler. It's been spoiled. It's been fried.
Yeah, it's been fried. No, it's going to be good fun. It's going to be good fun. So really, really looking forward to it. I think tickets are nearly sold out. Or they
last
might
I
be
looked,
sold out,
but it there was about less than 100 tickets. So yeah, there's a very high chance when you hear this, it may be sold out. But just to, in sort of a word of traditionally what happens with the Godney Gathering, it's really, really friendly because Roz has got a ticket in the past this way, is that if for any reason you can't go through the festival, the Godney Festival themselves, you can then send your ticket in to them, not the actual physical ticket, and yeah, swap the name, and it's at face value, and it's there's no sort of exploitation or anything. It's an extremely fair way of being able to pass on your ticket to someone.
Yeah, yeah. And there's normally
we got that and it worked brilliantly. So
yeah, yeah, it's well worth doing. There's always like one, two people on the on the day can't turn up, so
You just link up on the Facebook page. I think there's a Facebook page that you link up with, and you have to kind of register that first before you can do it.
Right, let's play some more music now. This is a language warning. This is just so you know, this is a track by the Scribes, and it's called Hype.
Come on, feet, start to
welcome to the Hype Train. Been in it for a minute, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the mind state. I've been in it to the finish, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the Hype Train. Been in it for a minute, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the mind state. I've been in it to the finish, mate. Welcome to the limit break.
Whoa, like I don't get hype, I stay hype. Bro, like I don't get down, I stage dive. Yo, like I don't beatbox, I spray fight. And write sharp as blades like my biro's a steak knife. Yum, best catch stage fright, I'm hungry. That bassline's my belly still rumbling. Son, I am done snatching crumbs. I am gunning for something much bigger. My filler is Cannibal Country. Ah, got sharks in my blood. Been building a big architecture. Ah, this part don't get ugly. Been killing this shit, Lord protect ya. Ah, limit break lyric weight. Heavy as a shipping crate, lifting weights. Flipping great, flip a script, flip a spit in your face. Wait, I stay hype on tracks. You
pot shots unseen like a Sasquatch. Lost thoughts get you popped in the snot box. I'm on my tippy toes. Call me Pee Wee Herman. I keep the heat in the closet. I call it Eric Sermon. Determined to be the best at it. A couple bad habits mixed with black magic. Heavy metal rap addict. Led Zeppelin, Black Sabbath. Dropping elbows. Macho, I'm Randy Savage. Collateral damage. Uncontrollable and hard to manage. Outlandish. The way I leave them bruised and bandaged. It's kill or be killed. This ain't a battle drill. Got the skills and I ain't dying on a battlefield. I can't stand still. Call it OCD and I ain't taking any pills. I'm blowing on trees. You can dig to China. Won't find a better rhymer. So forget about it. Alzheimer's.
Welcome to the Hype Train. Been in it for a minute, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the mind state. I've been in it to the finish, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the Hype Train. Been in it for a minute, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the mind state. I've been in it to the finish, mate. Welcome to the limit break.
How I roll, bring the hype like flavor flame. Keep the crowd in line like a rollerblade. Respect the grind, know your backside is finished, mate. Even on my back, that's a real first with the pain. Circus play, no challenge, keep the balance straight. Rappers like Impala, you ain't bright cause you're broken shade. Off, without the verses that detonate. Writing OB before I read to a pressure rate. Word juggle, pretty bloody flex and brain muscle. My juggle is vain, but puppy keeps your taste muddled. Wu-Tang, wolfing to protect during all struggles. I scuffle jinx who spit, leaving nut puddles. Puzzled over speakerphone, overblown. Keep cans banging in your head like Home Alone. While I go tete-tete and I tussle in my terror dome. You struggle with the alphabet like queer bashing home.
Welcome to the Hype Train, been in it for a minute, mate. Welcome to the limit break. Welcome to the mind state, I've been in it.
Okay, Talking About by Forgive and Forget, who is playing Silent Disco on the Saturday. So well worth going to. Chat about Godney Memories. I mean, you've done a few, haven't you?
I have always enjoyed going to Godney, and I've always found that, you know, both Sue and Mike and the whole team just very, very friendly. You know what I still love? I mean, it's also a Glastonbury Calling memory. It's seeing Funky in the Two Tone Baby is one of my memories, and just how, you know, he is just, he's made it. He's basically broken through and he's now doing most of the major festivals. So for me, that was an incredible memory because he has worked so hard to get where he is today, and just such a nice chap is Dan.
Yeah. Well, the first one I went to was the one that was called off, and because the area got flooded and they moved it out to Bridgewater in the hangar, and the subways headlined that one. And that was really good. And that was the first time I went down. And then the next year they moved it. It was moved, but not, it was on the road out to Godney as you go over the bridge. And they had the blockheads there. I had the acoustic tent, a little acoustic tent for GFM. And we had like Lonely Tourist playing there. So that was fantastic to have him playing there. And then they've moved to the site where it is now, which has been the best move ever. And the first one, Reef headlined, which was great. And, you know, we were down in a tent, so we had loads of great local acts on there. And that was it. You know, we've gone full circle back to the tent. But the main, the best thing ever for me was when they had UKID sub-headline, because they were one of my favourite local bands ever.
I remember that, yeah.
And that was like, that was just the best. That was one of the best 45 minutes of my life, I think, went watching them on the main stage.
I loved watching, do you remember, I think they've got back together with the lineup change of the Jacks. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah.
They were on the brink, and then they there was a bit of a hiatus. But they played in the second stage at Godney, and that was a brilliant set. Not that many people there, but it was a really energized set. So that was a highlight for me.
Yeah, one of my favourite sets on our stage was I Destroy. Because I absolutely love I Destroy, and they just blow you away. They were really top band. I mean, they were really great. And we've had some amazing stuff.
Even last year, I just remember we were hanging out on the Glastonbury Calling stage, and just it was wonderful seeing Chateau Dato with their set on a sunny day last year. That was a really nice moment. The sound was really good. And for me, it's all about a moment, you know, a gig. It may or may not be your quiet taste. It's just the atmosphere. It was a really chilled atmosphere.
Yes.
Some people started to get up and move around a bit as well. So I really enjoyed that last year.
Yeah, it was just starting to cool down a bit, wasn't it, that time?
It was a hot one.
Because it was so hot. Yeah. I mean, you think about this time last year, we were in the middle of that heat wave, weren't we? That was hard work. That was really worse. And I wouldn't have fit then as I was now. So I was
back to the weather. At least at the moment, I mean, I'm looking out, you know, now, and, you know, you get a bit of rain, but then the sun still comes out and it is warm. So, you know, it's okay. And actually, the cloud gives you a bit of cover. It means you can just dance that much harder, because it's important just to make sure that we all drink a bit. I got a bit forgetful at Pretty last week and was a bit worse for wear. That was a hot one on that last Friday. Sounds a brilliant event. Hope it goes well. I'm sure it will. And have a great time, everyone.
Yeah, have great fun. Right, let's play some more music from acts that are playing. These are all new tracks I've got from people. So this is a track called Star Signs, and it's by Bridges.
Rosy red lawn, green licorice and sherbet. When did I
something else. Looking up one in three. Never liked to gamble, but the more that I read, it only gets larger. They say that it's you. You have us all shaken and stirred. Try to take it all. 'Cause I'm one of four. Always the eldest. As time goes on, boy, do I feel it. They say that it's you. All shaken and stirred. Hell on earth, if the wrong one chooses you. Know that you're scared. We're so proud to feel that too. Our love.
Table that you've put me on, crawling in the the darkness, trying to find a plate to eat upon. Scrounging at your knees, begging please, I need to eat. Leftover sadness, please, joy still stuck between my teeth. Feed me emotions, it's the only thing that lets me breathe. Now leave me alone, please, give me all the time to eat. Cause I don't wanna lose the sensation. It's got me running, got me feeling vacant. No, cause I don't wanna lose the sensation, but
Vacant there by Beware of Leopards. Played that last week, but you know, happy to play it again because they're playing our stage. So there was one or two acts that I couldn't get music from because weren't available, which was on our stage, which was Ravello Drive and Grove Warden. I couldn't get a track off of them. An Absolute Zero just in the moment in doing their first ever recording. So we might get. In the near future, we might get some Absolute Zero music as well to play on the podcast. So, yeah, all good stuff. So, other gigs on this weekend. On Thursday, Grizzly Rees Morgan is playing the King Arthur. On Friday, there's Electric Rude Boy, which is DJ Drama Queen, Dr. Armour Queen. This is Carl's final, well, it's not his final ever gig, but it's his final gig in Glastonbury as a resident because he's moving up to Bristol now and trying to get out there because he's up at university there doing an art degree. So it's his so I think if anyone's about in the Arthur, it'd be a bit of a party on Friday night anyway. Distant House, Virus, Any Minute No, and SFA. Rob is putting on a punk gig at the King Arthur on Saturday night, so that's going to be exciting. If you're not at Godney, get down to that. That'll be really, really good. Ingenious Fig. That's one I was struggling with reading my writing. I was thinking, what do I write there? Ingenious Fig. They're playing at the Rife's on Saturday, and Show and Dance at the Red Brick Building. It's a show and dance, a night of reggae music or a day of reggae music at the Red Brick. So there's some stuff on if you're not going to Godney and you haven't got a ticket and you want to go and check some stuff out. I definitely say if you're into punk music, go to the gig on Saturday night because it's free as well. So that'll be, you know, it's a cracking night. So a good alternative if you want something to do this weekend. So what are you up to the weekend?
So going to a gig on Saturday night at the David Hall in South Peverton to see a duo called The Breath. They're on Real World Records. It's kind of dreamscape, really melodic. So it's kind of a chill thing. I've got friends from Australia that come over annually because my friend Tim's dad lives in the UK, so they come over. So hopefully they'll be joining us, and we're all going to go to this gig together. So I've seen them before at Valley Fest, and it's Riona Connolly, I think, is the lead singer. She's got the most amazing voice with this incredibly perfect Irish sense of humor. So I'm really looking forward to The Breath, a really, really good group. So that's for me. Sunday, no plans. Saturday, and The Breath.
Yeah, I've got to come down and check that venue sometime. sometime in the future.
I'm not around, but in October, Cut Capers have got a new album due, and they're playing there.
Well, I didn't want to come down if you're there.
Oh, okay. But you can still go and see them, because I might have to go and see Cut Capers in Exeter. I love Cut Capers.
Tell them to get Lonely Tourist down there or Funky.
Yeah, that's true. I don't have that influence, but I am building up a list of, should we just say, our acts to send on to some of the team. But the Priddish Brothers played as supports before, so they do get local acts, actually. Yeah, so... Yeah, no, Cut Capers will be good. Going to see Merry Hell in December. They're a good sort of like a show of hands band. So
Yeah.
They've had like Rin Tins, and they've had quite a few good acts on, actually, Mr. T.
Yeah, they do have good acts there. And I'll have to check out their lineup, what they got coming up in the future then, see if there's anything that's, interesting for me and Karen, really.
Put on Cosmic Ninja, that would go down well, wouldn't it?
Oh, yeah. I bet that would shake
the house down.
Yeah. I bet they've never had anything that loud in there.
I'm not so sure, but it would be interesting. It's all going in. I might put this forward, actually. It's a nice little venue. So it's nice to have sort of local music within Somerset that we can just get out to rather than going into Bristol.
Yeah. It's good to have some on your doorstep anyway. Mm. So I'll be at Godney all weekend. There's another thing that I'm probably going to on Sunday, just because it's easy, not because I'm all festival. Like, we've got a food fair on in Boltonsborough, so they've got big marquee and bar and a big sharing table in the middle, so you can go and buy your food, loads of vegan food and vegetarian food as well. They have got some live music. I don't know what the live music is, but they have got some live music.
The Shenanigans are going to be there.
The Shenanigans, yeah,
they're headlining. Yeah,
yeah.
A guy called Ian something, Ian Bridges or something, Ian is Bridges. On the lead vocals and dance.
Yeah. I mean that'd be a good tribute act as well, wouldn't it?
Yes.
The Shenanigan Twain.
Yeah, you could have a dance version of Shania Twain.
Yeah,
this is getting ridiculous. I think we are going into sort of science fantasy now here, or musical fantasy.
Yeah,
we better bring it back now.
We better bring it back. We better go, really.
Yeah, I guess so.
Better go and get some food, because we've been working hard today.
It's been a hard day's afternoon, and you've been working like a postie.
We deserve some tea and some beer, I think.
Yeah. Tea and Beer, that's another track of the Shenanigans album. This album's going to be released very, very soon. Maybe what we should say, it gets put off each year. So in about 20 years' time, when I'm of a certain age, more than I am now, is that Shenanigans album out? No, they're still working on it. We could be pretending this album's never going to get released, but pretend it's imminent. Yeah, anyway, everyone, thank you for putting up with us for yet another week, and enjoy Godney Gathering.
Yeah, have a lovely weekend, and get out to a gig, get out some music this weekend anyway.
Yeah, do it.
Take care.
Bye.